Welcome back to Ring of Fire. I'm Mike Papantonio. The Monsanto Corporation has been working to create genetically modified foods for decades. Most of the times, consumers don't even know what they're eating. It is Monsanto's Frankenstein creation. I have attorney Howard Nations with me now to talk about what's happening to your food supply. Howard, party around Monsanto today and this entire year. What a gift they've been given. Can you imagine being the gift? No other industry I know that can't be sued for negligence. They can't be sued for causing harm to farmers. They can't be sued for causing harm to consumers. But this is a Congress that snuck in to the budget this relief bill for Monsanto. Tell us the GMO story in general.
The story of GMOs is that allegedly they're to increase the food supply for the hungry people of the world. The fact of the matter is that the real reason for the modification is that 75% of them are to increase crop tolerance of herbicides. 50% of them alone are to withstand Monsanto's Roundup herbicide. So that's what GMOs are all about.
Why is that? Why is that so important? In other words, they're making a crop. It's a Franken crop. It's a Frankenstein variation of corn and soybeans and rice. And it's this thing we haven't tested. We don't know whether it kills us in the long term or not. We know it kills rats because we tested that. Right. But we don't know if it kills humans. But what is the part of the Roundup story that people miss here?
Well, the problem with GMOs essentially is that these are not the standard hybrid that increases the number of plants you can produce. This is specifically to tolerate Roundup, the Monsanto product, and other herbicides. So we're producing a whole new group of modified foods that will tolerate Roundup. Now, the Roundup story is essentially they found that Roundup has been associated with miscarriage, birth defects, neurological development problems, DNA damage.
Okay, so we know this. Okay, so Congress knows this going into it. They know that this is purely a money issue. You see, now if a farmer has to almost use these products because Monsanto is able to say, listen, we're the only ones who make this product that can withstand a Roundup herbicide. We've made this for you. Now, the farmer is out there realizing that once he plants that seed, it's over for his conventional or his or her conventional crop, right? Once it's in the ground, it's over for the future of that farm, isn't it?
That's true, because this is shocking, but 70% of the products in the United States contain ingredients of GMOs. And you would think that since there are obvious problems with it, there should be mandatory labeling. But when we try to get to mandatory labeling, which is supported by 90% of Americans, and which 64 other countries require, there's been this great outcry from agribusiness. They spent $50 million, led by Monsanto, to defeat Proposition 37 in California that would simply warn Americans, consumers, about the fact that GMOs are in their products. Now, if there's nothing wrong with the food, if there's nothing wrong with the GMO, why are they so worried about us knowing about it? And then, of course, you come to what you opened with, which is the Monsanto Protection Act. This is one of the most outrageous things I've seen come out of an outrageous Congress. As we were approaching the fiscal cliff this year, remember back in March, a provision was anonymously placed into the legislation that said, amazingly, that if a judge has proven in his courtroom that GMOs are hazardous, risky to the health of consumers, that a court cannot stop the growth and sale of those products. Now, that was placed in by Senator Roy. It was originally placed in anonymously. It was traced back to Senator Roy Blunt from Missouri, who incidentally has received $716,000 from agribusiness this year. Last month, the Democrats tried to take it out. In the current farm bill that's before the Senate right now. They include the provision to take the Monsanto Protection Act out. The amendment was killed by Senator Blunt.
Okay, so, let me, just in this last 30 seconds, here's what's important. It's a product that hasn't been tested on humans. We don't know, no epidemiology to tell us what is up with this thing. The only tests that we have show that the product has the propensity to kill rats, cause cancer, cause tumors, cause neurological problems. We have an administration who knows all of that, but we also, by the way, Howard, also have an administration that's put one of the key advisors to this administration happens to have Monsanto contacts and roots that are a mile long. This is a story that really our children and grandchildren are going to be affected by. Howard, I appreciate you following this. This is the tip of the iceberg right here, and we're going to really hear the end of the story about 10 years from now when we start seeing what all of this yields. Thank you for joining me, Howard Nations.
Thank you, Mike.